It's the drought within. It's the desert that I've swallowed. It's the dryness of my prayers. It's this coarse and cracking faith, so mirroring the coarse and cracking ground beneath my feet. It's this parched belief, the thirst that first and third worlds share, the thirst of souls that spend themselves building wells and digging holes and finding ways to subsist, sustain, survive in the desert, resolutely attempting to thrive in the desert, but we weren't made for this lingering death, for valleys of shadows, for dry bones. We were created Eden folk. We were born to live in gardens. Which is why it seems a cruelty to be caught in such a desert, to have this desert caught in me. I confess, I am walking, breathing barrenness. I myself am desert, housing only doubt, mirage, no fit home for creeping things, let alone a king of kings, no reprieve to give to those who thirst, nothing to offer those in need, no life in me, and nothing green, just a colorless stretch and thirst enfleshed, a living sign of want and lack. And yet, you call me life, salt, light, song. You refute death as my destiny. You call me new creation. Call me desert made oasis. You declare that in the midst of empty stretches, in what was once all lack and absence, here I build my kingdom, not like the kingdoms of the earth. Here I till the dry, dry dirt. Here I make my rivers run. And here I plant my truth over and over again until it grows up strong and thick, until it bears its rightful fruit. O long-lost Eden children, you have begun your journey home in the footsteps of my precious son, the ever-resurrected one, the God-man who shamed this deathly drought when he tasted it and spit it out. The desert could not make its home inside Eve's long-sought holy son. It couldn't claim this second Adam. He belonged to greener things. His being was and is oasis. He is life for those who taste him. And he tells us to abide in him, and he in turn will live in us. And in this place of scarcity, we will have enough. Trudging onward then we climb, knowing that one day enough will be abundance. And this oasis turned to garden. And in this garden, we will know the life we lost. In this garden, plants will grow up to father forests. In this garden, seeds will beg to be wed with soil and sunlight, and there will be no winter to cut short the harvest. And in this garden, there will be no want for harvesters. It will be like Eden, but without chance of defeat. Like Eden, but with no temptation slithering through the trees. Like Eden, but without death waiting, his fingers curled around the gate. Like Eden, but the communion stretches on, uninterrupted, without breach. Like Eden, but not like an oasis. Not a single fertile seed buried deep in desert stomach, but a paradise stretching on over city, slum, and country, green over all the earth, flowers lit in deadened eyes. Like Eden, but eternal, and internal, and all, like Eden, but not on the edge of a fall, like Eden ever after resurrection. A garden never again to wither, a world never again to thirst, and no desert, no drought, not in soul, in body, or in earth, a new creation, my dear friends, begun in us and destined to spread to the edges of existence and the darkest parts of men, a new creation. Begun in us, and soon to be brought to completion.